after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, where is he who is born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him. Verse 3. When Herod the king heard this, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. Verse 4. When he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. And the last verse. So they said to him, in Bethlehem of Judea, for thus is written by the prophet, by you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judea, are not the least among the rulers of Judah, for out of you shall come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel. Amen.
Amen. Matthew asempai timi enu ni mu ba kwesi num no. O se na bo bu Yesu Bethlehem a ewo Judea. Onye ne Herod breso no. Hwe anyansefo bi firi epoye ba Jerusalem. Be kan se ehin na Judafo ahene a wawo no no. Na yehunu ne nsoma we epoye na ye ba abesore no. Na onyene Herod teye no. Oni Judafo nyina akometui. Na osia omanu mu asafo mpanifo ne atwerefo nyina bisa won. Fa kwa bo bebu Kristo no. Na waka kire no se Bethlehem a ewo Judea. Na sabra na na odifo no atwere se. Na wo Bethlehem Juda asase. Wo nye Juda asafo asafo hene mu ekuma. Efrise wo mu na osafo hene a wo behwe mema Israel so no befri aba. Amen.
Take your miracle seat.
Eni de kwa nso betumi atena se.
Put your hands together for Jesus.
Na ba won sam kase pa ma asafo Ewurade.
Bethlehem. Now I'm preaching on what I have titled The Star from Bethlehem.
Ye ka instrument efri Bethlehem mu asem.
Can we all say the star from Bethlehem?
Instrument efri Bethlehem mu asem na no peye ka.
The name Bethlehem simply means house of bread.
Bethlehem asiche na nsepan no fie.
The ancient name of Bethlehem used to be Euphrates or Ephrata.
Titibrem no ye fre Bethlehem Euphrates ana Ephrata.
If you remember the name of Joseph's sons.
So what kind of Joseph mana?
So the ancient name of Bethlehem was Ephrat or Ephrata.
And Titibrem no ye fre Bethlehem Ephraim ana Ephrata.
And Ephraim or Ephrata means fruitfulness.
Na Ephrata se kire ne abaso.
And Bethlehem was one of the cities of Judah.
Na Bethlehem eye Judah nkro no mu baako.
But it was not among the chief cities or the principal cities of Judah.
Na enka ahemfo nkro no mu bi.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Though Bethlehem was among the cities of Judah,
na Bethlehem eke Judah nkro no mu bi de.
It was noted by so many things. And I'm going to give you three of the notable things about
Bethlehem.
Now, according to the reading, Bethlehem was a place where Boaz and Ruth were born.
Bethlehem eye kura ya wo Ruth ene Boaz wo mu.
According to Ruth chapter 1 and verse 19.
Said the Luke as and petiba ko yimu dunkru no sie no.
Bethlehem was also the city of David, the birthplace of David.
Bethlehem eye bia ya wo ohene David nso.
According to 1 Samuel chapter 17 and verse 12.
Said the Samuel woman di kan tetiba ko yimu dumi.
And in ancient times,
tetibre ni mu no,
Bethlehem was a fortified city by a king called Rehoboam.
Na Bethlehem eye kura na enho oden e wo Rehoboam breso.
He fortified the city.
Ono na o se kuro no ma kuro ni yeden.
Then Bethlehem also became the place where Jesus was born.
And Bethlehem was beye bia ye wo ye na agen kwa Jesus Christ.
Praise the living God.
Hallelujah.
So we are talking about a place.
Ye kasafa bia.
David came out of that place.
Ye wo ohene David free ye.
Boaz and Ruth came out of that place.
Boaz any root to fit say kro kro na
mu. Was strengthened by a king Rehoboam.
And Rehoboam was best kro na ye eten.
Jesus also was born out of Bethlehem.
Christ also ya woni fi kro Bethlehem mu.
Hallelujah to Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah somebody.
Amen.
But according to today's reading,
said the enak and kan sam ni sitie no.
When Jesus was born in Bethlehem.
Bethlehem.
The scripture says a certain king called Herod was troubled. Let's go back and read it.
Matthew chapter 2, verse 3.
When Herod the king heard this, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are you with me?
Oh,
praise God.
Hallelujah.
Bethlehem produced so many people.
Bethlehem, I did say,
it was the place David came from. But nobody was disturbed. It was a place that gave birth to Boaz and Ruth. Nobody was disturbed. It was a place that produced so many things. But nobody was troubled. But when a star was born in Bethlehem, the Bible says a certain king was troubled. I have come to announce to somebody that you may have been born from a particular town, a particular family, a particular geographical location.
But
out of a place, you are coming out as a star. Out of that place, you are emerging as a superstar. I hope I'm hitting home
something.
Say, Bethlehem gave birth to David and people of ancient
times.
But what actually disturbed
me
was the fact that when a certain boy was born,
and he said,
the king could not hold his peace. The Herod of that time was troubled.
Herod,
I want to believe that it was because he knew the particular star that was about to take over the whole universe. Praise the living God.
Hallelujah.
So the reading says in Matthew chapter
2,
and verse number 5. Let's go there. So in Bethlehem of Judea, that's written by the prophet. You, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are not the least among the rulers of Judah, but out of you shall come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel.
Amen.
Praise the living God. Out of Bethlehem.
Bethlehem.
I said it was not a well-known city among the chief cities. Is somebody following my message? Let me see your hand. Ask your neighbor. Where were you born? Praise God.
Hallelujah.
No, you need to talk about where were you born? Some of you, your hometown cannot be geographically located on Ghana map. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
If you pick a Ghana map and you want to trace your hometown, you can never geographically locate it. And because of that, you have selected another so-called big city to belong to. When you are asked, where were you born? You say, I am an Efanti. Which part of Fanti land? It's unimaginable.
Because
you are, where do you come from? Where were you born? So me, I am an Equiapim man. Which part of Equiapim?
Equiapim.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jesus was born at a place that had few challenges. But out of that place, I'm saying out of that place, out of that place, out of that place, he became a star. Out of that place, he became a star. And I want to tell somebody that even as we cross over to the year 2020, I can see God making stars. I can see God producing stars out of a certain place, out of a certain family, out of a certain environment. It may not be geographically located, but the star will help to identify the place. I can see God releasing 100 stars in the house. 100 stars to enter 2020. Bethlehem had few challenges. Number one, the Bible calls it the least among the tribes. All the tribes of Judah. Bethlehem was the least among the tribes. You may be a least person in life.
When
you say you are least, it means you have something little to show. You don't have much to show. You are least in life. You are not known by anybody. You cannot be easily identified when you are put in the midst of about 200 people. But I have a good news for you, that a star came out of Bethlehem. In 2020, you can emerge a star in the name of Jesus. I prophesy over this church. It may be like a Bethlehem church, a church that is not on TV, a church that is not on radio, a church that is not situated in Accra, a church that doesn't have much to show, but out of the same church, God is raising stars. God is producing stars in the name of Jesus. Bethlehem was a place of littleness of strength. It was a city that is not that well known. It was a city that wasn't producing princes. Oh, I'm happy to announce. Bethlehem was also a place of famine and scarcity. How did I know that it was a place of famine? It was in Bethlehem that Naomi and the family left for Moab in search of greener pastures. Because there was famine in the land. So Naomi and Boaz, they left Bethlehem. It is like people who are leaving the shores of Ghana. They are saying that Ghana is hard. Ghana is difficult. The city is running from the citizens of the country. You have a city today, and come the next 2 weeks, it has really depreciated in value. So people are really running out of the country, looking for greener pastures. But I choose to stay in Ghana. I have chosen to stay here. Let those who want to go, let them go. I have chosen to be in Ghana. Out of Ghana, out of this country, God will produce a star. I say God will produce a star. Bethlehem was a place of scarcity. And it could be likened to our own motherland, Ghana, where $1 is equivalent to about six. Is this six or seven cities? Almost seven cities.
America dollar back. What is the second Ghana city in song?
American dollar, $1.
Dollar back on America memo
is equivalent to six Ghana cities.
What the back Ghana memo a city in Sia and in song?
What an economy!
Or my belly.
€1.
A euro back.
is equivalent to 8 cedis or more.
€1.
Ask your neighbor, how much is one Ghana compared to Naira?
Now what the Ghana compared to Naira? What should I say?
So weak.
Emreye.
So fragile.
Aboto ayohojo.
In the competition market, the Ghanaian currency doesn't match. And because of that, if you want to be an international businessman or woman, you need to go and change your Ghanaian cedis. Convert your Ghanaian cedis into dollars or euros or pounds. What an economy! It is like Bethlehem, a place of scarcity, a place of famine. Out of that place, a star was born, a star was produced. I announce to you, your family may be equivalent to the circumstances of Bethlehem, but I see God bring a star. This message is not for the whole church. I came to speak to few people under the sound of my voice, that you may be coming from a family, from a nation, a country, a tribe that is not well known. Your educational institutions, talk about the Ghanaian certificate. When you travel outside Ghana with a Ghanaian certificate, the only credential powers you are given is the fact that you are able to read and write. That is how far the Ghanaian certificate can take us. Because we have borrowed educational institutions. Before you write exams, the apport is sitting on your table. Praise the living God.
Hallelujah.
This is the country we belong. But I have come with a word. God will produce certain generals. God will produce certain stars. I have seen it in my lifestyle. God raising generals from Ghana and using them to compete with other nations. I have come to announce to the church, somebody should get ready. The year 2020, a star is about to be made known. A hidden star is about to be revealed. God is about to release about 25,000 stars. Out of this church I speak. Out of this church I prophesy. May it be the portion of somebody. In the name of Jesus. Bethlehem, number 3, is a city noted for sheep business.
Hey.
It's noted for the business of sheep, goats, cattle. People are producing cars and aeroplane. You are producing sheep, cars, goats. You cannot match with Japan. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Producing high technological equipment. I'm not surprised that when Jesus was born, he was put in a manger. Because the best occupation in town for the Bethlehemites was to be a sheep man. Remember David? When he was anointed Bethlehem, he was taking care of the father's sheep. Bethlehem was well noted for sheep business.
Bethlehem,
the woman say, "I am from Bethlehem."
Bethlehem,
then you start smelling sheep.
Now once I say, "Born, say,
the sheep man is here."
Hey, Ujain, Abano.
People of sheep are
around.
Out of a place where big, well-established businesses were not found, God brought out a general. God brought out a superstar. A place of sheep business. Look into your family history. How many doctors have you? In the family, how many doctors have you? How many lawyers have your family produced? Hello?
Hi.
But if we are looking for the drunkards, If we are looking for the prostitutes, if we are looking for weed smokers,
hey,
if we are looking for all illiterates, praise God.
Hallelujah.
They can be sampled out of your family. Mercy.
I said
mercy.
See,
when you come from such a place, in my family, for instance,
so for
the highest person in that family has completed junior high school. You have your PhD, you have your everything at JHS. What business would a JHS boy be able to do and accomplish? That is how far the family has raised up generals.
But
when Christ entered the family and found a star, Christ entered the family, found somebody in that family,
and
Jesus, God says, I'm going to make a superstar. I'm bringing princes out of the place. I'm bringing rulers out of the place. A place that was not meant for the raising up of rulers.
We
saw the emergence of a ruler. I want to transfer the same prophecy about Jesus upon the destinies of somebody, that you may not have any lucrative business in your family. Even if you are prophesied upon that God is bringing you an assistance, you look to the left, you look to the right, you look backwards and you look forward, then you ask yourself, who in the family is ready to help me? I came to announce to you an external help. An external figure. An external power. An external strength is about to pass parachute somebody in 2020. Somebody should be getting ready to become a ruler out of a community that does not produce rulers. In the name of Jesus. I said, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Put your hands together and give me a better amen. I said, I'm talking about the star from Bethlehem. And I want somebody to personalize this message that come 2020, a star is coming out of Pastor John's family. A star is coming out of Oyoko clan. A star is coming out of Breto clan. A star is coming out of Adriana clan. A star is coming out of, name me a clan, Asuna clan, and may you be that star.
Yes, sir.
Your faith is weak to respond. Your faith is weak to accept. Your voice is too soft to embrace it. May God bring a star out of your own clan, out of your family tree, out of the genealogies of your ancestors, in the name of Jesus. Five things about the star, then I'll end my message. Number one, the star was going to be a ruling star. Say with me, a ruling star. Jesus came out as a ruling star. And in Revelation 19 and verse 15, kindly flip your Bibles to Revelation, the last book of the Bible.
A young woman, a church, a watch,
it's the book of Revelation.
Your friend, a decent woman,
and verse 15.
19,
verse
15.
And out of his mouth goeth a sharp sword, that with it he shall smite the nations, and he shall rule them with the rod of iron. He shall tread the winepress of the fierceness and wrath of the Almighty God. Amen.
Amen.
And he shall, and he had on his vesture and on a tie a name written, Makapataya.
Amen.
I am seeing something here which you are not seeing. He had on his vesture and on his tie a name written. A name is about to be written. Read for the hearing of the people.
Yohane di sam etidunkuru nyimu dunum ne sey na afra na nan bi firi nanu mu.
A sword shall come out of your mouth.
O tena afra be firi wonu mu
aba. As a sword shall come out of your mouth.
En grand tabi be firi wonu mu aba.
When you stand in 2020 to speak,
say what sorrow I feel
the your words will be too sharp for the enemy to handle.
Some how can I no be your
number. My God, I am not prophesying and preaching to people in this church.
Until the year can I say.
As a when you stand to speak in 2020,
that what you know I feel
the enemy. Your words will be like a sharp sword.
En some how can I no be your number say afna.
And by your words,
now when some how can
you will smite enemy nations.
Come on.
By your words,
in some
by your declarations,
in some
you will smite enemy nations in the name of Jesus. And you are going to rule with the rod of iron.
I receive it.
And you, a name will be written on your vesture. The name will be King of Kings and Lord of Lords. As a King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Help me tell your neighbor. Help me tell your neighbor. This message is for me. God is addressing my future. God is addressing my 2020.
You see,
this is the message God laid on my heart. To share with the church as we cross over to 2020. Some of you, you are about to receive a red rating of a name. You didn't hear me. You are about to receive a rewriting of your name. In 2020, you had a name that was associated with sickness. 2019, you had a name that was associated with poverty. You had a name that was associated with prostitution, fornication, and all the negative stuff. Whenever your name is mentioned, in your neighborhood, people will start pointing at a certain figure. Oh, this lady,
we know her.
But as you cross over, I said, as you're about to cross over, there is a red written. Of a name that cannot be erased by human efforts. It's a name that will be written with the ink of the blood. With the ink of the blood. And you are going to be a king. It's a name that means you are a ruler. Receive the supernatural endowment. Receive the supernatural impartation. A name that will make you a ruler. Out of Bethlehem shall emerge a ruler, and the name will be written on the vesture of that ruler.
That
the King of Kings is coming. 2020. Why you show up? People will say, yeah, he's the one coming. People will not struggle to identify.
See,
anytime people are struggling for identification, it means we have common things available. When you have common things available, identification is difficult.
But
when something stands out, when something becomes peculiar, when a unique thing shows up, it becomes easy to identify. There may be so many stars in the sky, but when a unique star shows up, angels will burst into singing. So many stars stars were in the sky. But when the star of Jesus showed up, I saw multitudes of angels, joined the heavenly host of singers, and the choir of heaven with their heavenly robes. The choir of heaven got up and they began to sing about the star. People will stand up because a star is showing up, because a star is coming up, because a star is at birth, because God is producing a star out of a certain clan, out of a certain family, out of a certain community, out of a certain society. Person that God is generating and taking carnality out of that person. The supernaturality of God is stepping into the carnality of man. I see a superstar out of this church. I can see mega branch stars. Mega branch pastors, mega branch leaders, Matata Kapaya.
I receive it.
I said, God gave me a message for some people that a star is being generated. And I came with an announcement that your name has been set. Your name has been selected by divine selection, by divine appointment to be part of the star. Matata Kapaya.
I receive it.
A name that has never been known is about to be written concerning the destiny of somebody in the name of Jesus. Give a better resounding amen.
Amen.
My God said,
I receive
out of Bethlehem, out of Kingdom Paris, out of Mamiya and Papa Kofi Abusia, out of Sister Kia and Bra Kojo family, a family that cannot be given a better acronym. I see that family. A mega general is coming out. I am not teaching, I'm preaching. And at the same time, I'm prophesying. I didn't come to teach you steps. I have come to prophesy. And you may not know how it will happen. And you may not know when it will happen. But I have come to prophesy. That even in your marriage, a star will be made. Your marriage will be like a super marriage. That people will be talking about the marriage. And they will be describing.
Oh,
couple of days ago, I went to give a word of exhortation at a certain marriage. Just around Kenton
Crono.
When I got to the place, I saw the decoration. I saw the design. I went to two daughters. You were there. You were also there.
So I witnessed you.
When we got there, then the daughters came to me and said that,
and the doctor forbade us from jumping and say,
Pastor,
Sofu,
we wish that you give us the permission to decide where to have our marriages when our time is due. Why this request? Because they saw the beauty of the place. They saw the attractiveness of the place. When the woman appeared, is it the bridegroom or the bride? When the bride appeared, the garment alone was about 360 extension. So when she takes steps, we need to make way for the bride to
come.
Because the garment, the dress, was unusual. I speak upon the destiny. I decree upon the life. God is bringing a supernatural star that will affect your marriage.
Hey!
Hey! Give a better amen and
yes.
Now the second notable sign of the star was that it was a healing star. First one, it was a ruling star. Then number two, it was a healing star. Malachi chapter 4 and verse 2.
Malachi 4:2.
God is bringing healing out of this service.
I
said God is raising healing generals. Malachi chapter 4.
Malachi 4:9.
And verse number 2.
Malachi 4:2.
But unto you that fear my name shall the Son of Righteousness arise with healing in his wings. My God, with healing in his wings. Somebody didn't get it. With healing in his wings. And you shall go forth and grow up as calves of the stall. Somebody lift up your hand. Father, I pray before the end of the service, raise healing generals, raise healing stars, healing stars. Our world is sick of so many sicknesses, so many ailments. But may you be a healing star in that family, in that business, in that profession, in that ministry. May you be a healing star. When you show up, people will announce the healing man is in town, the healing woman is in town, the healing professor is in town, the healing minister. I speak it from my heart. God raise us healing people. God raise healing pastors. God raise healing generals. God raise healing men and women under the sound of my voice out of this church to affect Ghana, to affect the continent of Africa, to affect the continents beyond Africa. Give it to us, O God. Give it to us, O God. Give it to us, O God. Somebody shout, scream, receive, and cry. Shout, scream, and receive. Shout, scream, and receive.
I receive.
Shout, scream, receive, and cry. A healing star. I'm saying a healing star. I don't know about you. There's something that money cannot do. But when you become a healing star, your value will be more than money. Yes. You see, today, the best value in the world is gold.
And
when you become a healing star, you'll be more valuable than silver and gold. And God is producing them. Even in Bethlehem. Even in this classroom. Even in this mega house. A church that is yet to decide where the headquarters should be. So somebody will be like, so where is the headquarters of your church? You tell the person it's in Slovakia. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
When you say my church is headquartered in Ghana,
the
next immediate question will be, so who is the founder? But if you said your church's headquarters is in U.S.,
so
you said that, hey, then you are blessed. But
the
moment you say your headquarters in Ghana, you
ask yourself,
who is your founder? Why? Because Ghana is noted to be equivalent to Bethlehem. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
A place where famine is there, a place where scarcity is there, a place that does not produce princes. There is a man by the name Bishop Dagwood Mills. He is a man whose church is headquartered in Ghana. He is reaching the
whole nations of the world.
I said
something good will come out of this church. We may not be headquartered in South Africa. We may not be headquartered in
Japan.
We may not be producing cars. But we are a unique star. Producing healing. Bringing healing to nations. Bringing healing to the nations of the world. Give a better response. Clap your hands to Jesus and take your miracle seat for the next higher bullet. I'm preaching about the star of Bethlehem. The third notable feature of this star is that it is a saving star.
It's a saving star.
Church is a saving star. Matthew chapter 1 verse 21. Let us read Matthew
1:21.
He shall bring forth a son. And thou shalt call his name Jesus. For he shall save his people from their sins. You shall bring forth a son. Somebody is under the sound of my voice. He shall save his people from their sins. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
When Jesus appeared as a star, it was a reflection of salvation. The star of salvation. In Bethlehem, the star of salvation. I am speaking prophetically over certain key pastors, over certain key leaders. I am speaking upon the destinies of certain key church members that in 2020, God is making you a saving star. When you stand and there are deaths around. When there are deaths around, death, you will decree and declare life. And the dead will come back to life. In the city of Nain, somebody's child died. Was sent to the mortuary. After a couple of months, they had the final funeral rite. And the boy was in a coffin, heading towards the cemetery. And on their way, they met a savior. On their way, they met a star. When the star saw the coffin, he said, boy, your time is not ripe. You can't die just like that. Then this superstar touched the coffin. And the boy came out of the coffin, came to live again, to fulfill his destiny. I speak to somebody. God will use the words of your mouth. In 2020, people will come back to the saving knowledge of Christ. People will come back to the saving knowledge of Christ. When you stand to speak, I can see 500 preachers being brought out of this church. And as they preach to people, we are bringing salvation powers. We are bringing salvation powers. The Bible says in Obadiah 1:21 that Savior shall come out of Mount Zion. I see a star that is a Savior. The more you respond, the more it happens to you. The more you respond, the more you move into that dimension. It is the prophetic dimension of your destiny. And God is making you a Savior. In the name of Jesus.
If
as you ask you, what do
do you want to become in life? I will have very shocking responses and shocking answers.
Pastor,
I had a dream. And I had this lawyer thing on my head. I was sitting on a very high chair. And I was defending people. God bless you for that dream. I asked another person. What do you want to become in life? He said, Pastor, my family is hard. He said, I didn't ask of the family. But he will start with, my family is hard. God should help me. Pastor, I want to become a pilot. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Thank God for pilots.
Yeah,
I asked another person. What do you want to become in life? He says, Pastor, the way I have suffered in poverty, I want to be a businessman so that God will bless the work of God. Thank God for that businessman. But there is a unique calling. That cuts across all professions of life. Businessman can do it. Pilots can do it. Doctors can do it. Lawyers can do it.
It
is the call to be a savior of people. I said the call to be a savior of lost people. May God find that thing in your heart. May God find that grace in your heart. May God find that conviction in your spirit. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As I close, the last but one. Notable sign of the star of Bethlehem is that it was a shepherding star. Say with me, a shepherding star. One more time, a shepherding star. John chapter 10, verse 11 and 14. Jesus says, I am the good shepherd. Do you know that we have people who have allowed thieves to be their shepherd? People are following thieves as their shepherd leader. People are following thieves. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They have thieves as their shepherding leader. See the head and then the followers. But I have come to announce that your destiny will never fulfill negative prophecies. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
You are not here to fulfill negative prophecies. May you never become a leader over gangs. You are not getting me. May your children never rise up one day to become leaders over troubled people. Leaders over vagabonds.
Oh!
But Jesus says, I am a shepherding star. I have come to shepherd people to the Father. When he said, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life, you are saying that I am the good shepherd, and the good shepherd leads his people. 2020, I'm speaking over somebody's life. You will lead people in the path of righteousness. I said you will lead people in the path of righteousness in the name of Jesus. Clap your hands and receive it. Father, finally, the notable sign of the shape of the
star
was a defeating star. One more time. A defeating star. Isaiah 60 verse 1. Isaiah 60 verse 1. Rise and shine. For thy light has come. Are you there?
Yes.
Shall we all rise up?
Isaiah 60
verse 1.
Oye odifo Isaiah woman no etie duesia ne nyimba ko so resurrect na won han aba na ewrade enemunyam epie wo so. Amen.
The star that defeats other stars.
Ensunma e kan sunma huduro guo.
Your amen is weak.
Wa amen anu amre.
Today we have corrupt people who are also called stars.
And they won't crawl for what money up a promise from Monstroma.
When they show up in our sick room,
so Mupio or my Kumasi crowd,
the attendance alone is like the gathering of 17 churches.
Said the uncle for said, Jody, which I asked her for, but I could do so. I can't boom.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
We have these four stars.
Yeah, was Ansuma and your papa.
But 2020 and beyond.
Now, so I fear the enemy at
2020 and beyond.
I fear a day enemy at 12.
Oh, Father, make me one of the defeating stars. That when I shine, other stars will be transformed into darknesses. And then verse 18, the same scripture, verse 18. Violence shall no more be heard in your land.
Hey.
Matola Bakapaya.
I receive it.
Violence shall no more be heard in your land. Wasting nor destruction within thy borders. But thou shalt call thy walls salvation and the gate of praise. Your walls will be called walls of salvation. I say your walls will be called walls of salvation. Your walls will be called walls of praise. Because we are defeating demonic stars.
2020,
I prophesy. Demonic stars in my family. In my father's house. I am rising up to defeat them.
Yes, sorry,
demonic stars. That are deceiving people. God is making me a defeating star. A conquering star. Apostle Paul says that we are more than conquerors. Who is he that overcometh? But the one who had faith in Jesus Christ, he will be an overcoming star. An overcoming star. A defeating star. That defeats other stars. That overcomes other stars. Lift up your two hands.
We are
going to appropriate these 4 to 5 functions of the star. Now, what can
instruments do no more album?
Number one is a ruling star. The grace and the ability to rule in 2020. As a king in the name of Jesus. I want somebody to begin to talk to God. God, make me a ruling star. In 2020, I'm going to rule. In the name of
Jesus.
Rule over sickness. Rule over poverty. Rule over devils. The healing star. Make me an emblem of healing. Make me a healing tree. Make me a healing icon. An iconic of healing streams. Should be my destiny in 2020. Make me a saving star. When I show up, salvation will be the benefits of people around me. Salvation will be the portion of people. In the name of Jesus. Make me a shepherding star. I'm going to lead people, God. A leader of souls. Leading people to the house of God. Leading people to salvation in Christ. And I'm going to be an overcoming star. And I'm going to shine. A shining star. In the name of Jesus.
Yes, to them,
and appropriate them.